Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Residents along Varney Street in Manchester have now been allowed to return home. They were evacuated shortly after 5 this morning after a car hit a house and broke a gas line. No one was hurt, and the gas was shut off about an hour after the crash. That road has since been reopened. And road crews have been busy this morning. The state DOT says all of its crews are out treating icy roads. We have heard of reports of several crashes and slide-offs early this morning, mostly north and west of Manchester. So if you are heading out, allow a little bit of extra time this morning. Two people accused of causing a nearly 8-hour standoff in Hampton Falls yesterday are due in court today. Police say 36-year-old Darren Gregg and 32-year-old Melissa Amato were wanted by police in Amesbury, Massachusetts as part of an ongoing investigation. But when officers spotted them in a car outside a convenience store yesterday morning, they took off and eventually barricaded themselves inside their home on Lafayette Road in Hampton Falls. SWAT teams surrounded the home and negotiators worked for hours trying to convince the suspects to come out.
They were talking to the individuals through a megaphone, asking him to come out, and they kept repeating it, come out, come out. Keep your hands in the air, and everything will be fine, and we promise you'll be safe. They finally turned on the lights, and I saw two suspects come out with their hands in the air.
Investigators say they did recover several items from outside the suspect's car, items believed to be stolen. Both Darren Gregg and Melissa Amato are charged with burglary, but more charges are expected. House lawmakers are scheduled to vote today on a bill to legalize small amounts of marijuana for recreational use here in New Hampshire. The measure would allow people age 21 and older to legally possess up to an ounce of pot and grow up to 6 plants. The marijuana would be taxed when sold at retail, something supporters say would generate millions of dollars in revenue for the state. The Senate rejected a similar plan last year, and Governor Hassan said she would veto the measure if it reaches her desk. New Hampshire has a new Guinness Book of World Records record holder this morning. Jennifer Stanley of Tumbletown Gymnastics in Manchester pirouetted her way in by performing the most consecutive handstand pirouettes. She managed to complete 30 of them on her 5th try. She does admit she was starting to feel a little bit green with 7 to go, but was able to power through and reach her goal. Congratulations to her. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.